Hello and welcome to Libraries of Leaders with me, Mahima. This week we have one of India's most popular fiction writers and author of 4 best-selling novels. Ashwin, thanks for inviting us into your home.
Delighted that all of you are here, Mahima. Look forward to a very interesting chat.
Okay, so Ashwin, you have a beautiful library and I've seen so many books here, but I understand that you started off as a businessman and then you transitioned into an author. How did that happen?
Well, frankly, I must tell you, I was always born and brought up in a typical business environment. My education is economics education. My master's degree is in business administration, that too in finance. I came back sometime around 93 from the US after completing my studies. The furthest thing from my mind was that I would ever sit down to write a book. I was always a voracious reader. Mm-hmm. That was primarily on account of my grandfather, who used to encourage me to read and would gift me a book every week. But writing was not something that I had ever thought about seriously. And then suddenly what happened is that I ended up making a visit to Srinagar. Okay. And there is a tomb in Srinagar which is known as Roza Bal. And it's purportedly the resting place of Jesus Christ. That's the folklore around it.
Okay.
And I was obsessed by the story. So I spent the next 2 years writing, reading everything that I could about that particular subject. And it reached the point where my wife said that, listen, you know so much about it. Why don't you write something? And so that's what led to that book. But that was the turning point, as they say.
Oh, and after that, you've written quite a few books.
Oh, yeah.
Let's talk about your first series, so well received.
Yes.
Now, in that series, what I've seen is that you've taken these moralistic, idealistic characters and given them a shade of gray.
Yeah.
What urges you to do that?
Because that's human nature, isn't it? I mean, we are talking about people who, there isn't anything like the perfect human being. So even though we have characters like Ram and Krishna, but we find so many flaws. For me, for example, there is a streak of deviousness in Krishna.
Yeah.
And that's in fact what I like about him, that there is that streak of deviousness. So the point being that, or for example, if you take Chanakya, there was a streak of nationalism and idealism in the man, but there was also a streak of ruthlessness.
Yeah, that's true. And
why go far? The first book that I wrote, the Roza Bal line, today's Jesus Christ is worshipped as the Son of God, but probably in his times, he was a revolutionary of sorts. So, I mean, I think what I have always loved to play with is that gray zone between good and bad.
Oh. And what sort of a process do you follow when you sit down to write a, you know, maybe you're starting a book, or is there a process that you give to finding those characters, or, you know, is there some specific thing that you follow?
For me, it's always a rather cut and dry process. It's rather mechanical in that sense. I always start out with a story. I have a germ of a story in my mind that this is what I will be writing about. After that, it goes into a research phase where I'm looking to read up about the topic or meet people. And the research varies. Like, for example, the Krishna Ki, I did a ton of traveling to places like Mathura, Dwarka, Vrindavan, and so on and so forth before I actually got down to writing it. For example, Chanakya's chant was actually just devoted to reading the Arthashastra and Mudra Rakshas and understanding them at a different sort of level before I got down to writing. Sialkot saga involved interviews with people because I hadn't lived through the India of 1950s and 60s. So I didn't know how to create that atmosphere in the book without talking to people who had lived through those times.
And what was that experience like, speaking, getting first-hand or second-hand accounts of,
that's the fun bit. People tell me that, oh, it must be so difficult to write books which involve so much research. But the research is what actually I love. That's what really makes that entire project fun. So for me, typically that research can last anywhere between 6 months and a year. And then I sit down to plot. Plotting is again a very, very scientific process. I normally will sit down with an Excel spreadsheet and work out the chapter outlines, typically explaining each chapter in about 100 odd words.
Okay.
And once I have the outline in front of me, then it's pretty much like a coloring book where I already have the outline in front of me. And then I just need to figure out that does it, should I use red here or green here or blue here? It's pretty much that. So most of my books in the Bharat series, yeah, end up taking anywhere between 12 months and 24 months to actually finish.
That's a long run process.
Yeah.
So with all your popularity and the, you know, good wishes that you've received, is there any pressure to write a certain way, or is there any pressure to even deliver books at a certain time from your publishers or maybe even from yourself?
I think it's a two-pronged process, really. Mm-hmm. There's a flip side to every story. So on the one hand, when you are more popular, the advantage is that your publisher is willing to take you seriously even if you're looking at something which is out there.
Mm.
So the chances of an out there project getting published is that much higher. On the other hand, you also get somewhat limited by your audience, because there are expectations of your audience to deliver more of the same. So to that extent, you have to balance those two. So on the one hand, you do have freedom to explore other stuff, but you're also slightly hemmed in by the expectations of your readers.
But you have deviated a bit when it comes to the 13-step series.
13-step series or my crime thrillers with Patterson, all of those are completely different from my Bharat series. You know, people say that how do you sort of switch gears? But I'm actually very happy because it's like a breath of fresh air.
Yeah.
I'm able to do something which is completely different.
So what do you plan with your 13-step series? We've had three books come out now. We have Good Luck, we have Wealth, we have Marks now.
Yeah.
Students will love that.
Well, students won't love it, but nevertheless, it's probably worthwhile reading because it teaches you to study more efficiently.
Oh.
But the intention of the 13-step series, what I have, when I've been looking around and the sort of people that I've been meeting when I go for my talks, is that virtually everyone is an expert on something or the other, but it's just that they don't know it. So everyone has a domain expertise in some area. The problem is that very often they aren't able to communicate what they know. So the 13-step series will be an entirely co-authored series.
Okay.
So I two of the books already within the series have been co-authored.
Yeah.
The Wealth book was with Sunil Dalal and the Marks book was with Ashok Rajani. Going forward, we have multiple topics being covered, including a book on sales, including a book on communication, including books on health and cooking and travel and what have you. So the intention is to make this into a full-blown series where the vertical domain expertise will be brought in by a co-author and the storytelling skills will be brought in by me.
So you are already have and you will co-author this series, but you've also done that with James Patterson in private series.
That's right.
So what was that like?
Incredible because, you know, with a crime thriller, the critical element, of course, is in terms of ensuring that you can keep the reader hooked to every short chapter that comes along and you magnify the suspense and amplify the thrill. So typically the way we work is we start out with a plot outline. The plot outline itself ends up taking probably more time than the actual writing because the plot outline is where you pretty much map out every twist or turn in the story, and that's the time when the back and forth between me and James Patterson tends to be far higher than usual. Once we actually get down to writing, there isn't really much back and forth because the storyline has already been decided.
So do you all split chapters between yourself or even...
No, the way it works is typically the first draft is written by me. The second and third drafts are written by James.
Okay.
Because he is truly a master of the thrill. That's a formula that he has understood perfectly. He's got it down pat. At certain points of time, I may bring in a certain subject or a character and he may say, you know, if we weren't to bring this in, let's say chapter 30 and we brought it in chapter 50, we would be ending up heightening the suspense. So he loves doing that. And I think it works.
It works. Most definitely. And so now you have written about theology, you have delved into politics, all within your fiction genre. And now you've also sort of come up with this self-help dummies sort of a book series. So, is there anything else that you've really been wanting to write about?
I would say the one topic or the one genre that I would love to eventually write in is probably science fiction and the paranormal. Both those interest me tremendously.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that because I am already working on books within multiple spaces, it's very difficult for me to actually get down to giving the sort of time that is needed for the research in those other books. But at some point, like for example, if you ask me, will you ever write a romance novel?
Hmm.
I don't think I'm going to write a romance novel because my mind just doesn't work in that direction. But science fiction, yes. Horror, possibly. Paranormal, yes. So those are spaces which at some point of time, I hope that I'll explore.
So when it comes to science fiction, I'm a fan too. What, you know, really puts you in there? Like, is there a show? Is there a book? Is there just a writer that really inspires you there?
I would say that, in fact, frankly, it's more than science fiction.
Yeah.
It's probably science that inspires me. For example, I'm delighted when I'm reading, let's say, for example, Stephen Hawking, or I'm reading Richard Dawkins. I mean, so I love that because it, even in terms of the sort of books that I end up reading, I'm, you know, like, for example, there is a book by Gary Zukav. We'll talk about later, about it later. But that's a book which, you know, talks about the fact that there is so much in common between quantum physics and the spirituality that we are used to in India. So those are the sort of spaces that I love reading in. And probably at some point of time, writing in.
That would be such an interesting one. Thank you, Ashwin, so much for talking to us.
Pleasure talking to you, Mahima.
Do tune in next week to see what other leaders are reading. Thanks for watching Bloomberg Quint.